Neverhome is the story of Ash Thompson. It's set during the American Civil War. And Ash is a woman who grows up on a farm in Indiana. And she decides to go to war and obviously has to dress up as a man. And the story is one of a degree of deceit and disguise. But it's not just about her gender, because she discovers all sorts of things about what it is to be at war, about battle. She goes through horrible things. And at the end, she finally makes her way back home. But as the title describes, you can't ever quite make your way back home without being scarred by the battles you've lived through. So I was sent Neverhome by a literary agent, and it came to Sunday night. And as is often the case when one is an editor, one does a lot of one's reading on a Sunday night. And I sat down with it and I read it, which is very rare, in one go. It was the most intense experience. It sort of came at me like a punch. It's an extraordinary novel, and it's all in the voice. No, Ash is this completely beguiling, quite mysterious. She never quite gives herself away. She's an extraordinary heroine, and she completely, she sort of undermines your portrayal of her constantly. So you're sort of always trying to kind of catch her up and find out exactly what she's up to. And it makes for a very compelling and intense read. So it was a book that couldn't really let me go. And the Monday morning, I went in and the first thing I did was call the agent. And by that Friday, I had bought the book. And it's very rare that it happens that quickly, but it's testament to what an extraordinary book it is that it did. And, you know, a couple of years later, we're now publishing it. Oh, I'm almost loath to tell you, because the final scene is so, so powerful. I couldn't quite believe it had happened. I almost had to reread it. And when I came in a few days later, having read it and started talking to colleagues, they too were saying, did it really happen? Was that really the end? Gosh, I can't believe it. But because I can't really tell you about that, the thing that really sticks with me is the opening line of the book. I was strong and he was not, so it was me that went to war. It always felt like the most definitive statement, a statement of someone who is burdened with duty and trouble, but yet has this kind of burning ambition and desire to go and see the world.